Hey, loan officers, want to let you know my good friends over at Oak Tree Funding, they have 24-hour turn times right now in underwriting. They're absolutely jamming. It's not just because things are slower across the board for everybody, it's because they invested in technology and they have streamlined their process. So if you want great, fast turn times with some of the best rates you're going to get in non-QM, I'm telling you, talk to my friends over at Oak Tree. All you have to do is click this banner right over there. So according to Lynn Kiefer, yes, that's his name, not Ken Leifer, it's Lynn Kiefer, and he's the deputy chief economist at Freddie Mac. He says that the United States housing market is at the beginning stages of the most significant contraction in activity since 2006. And according to the Freddie Mac Home Purchase Mortgage Application Index for the United States, purchase applications are now down 40% from the seasonally adjusted peak. And we say, I don't know, maybe this Lynn guy's wrong. Let me give you an example.
Sure. Applications are down 40%, but the real question is this. How many pre-qualified, pre-approved borrowers does an average loan officer have in their pipeline right now? Because the answer is super high. All of those borrowers who qualified in the twos and the threes and couldn't or didn't do anything are still there. You might need to get new findings at new rates and new loan amounts, but they're still there. Second point.
I mean, Len, you gotta look at this stuff. We still don't have any inventory. Now, this graph from the Fed, which, by the way, is the St. Louis Federal Reserve, it shows the inventory amounts we have now versus this time last year. And of course, our inventory has gone up recently as mortgage rates have basically doubled. But you'll note that we're still way down off our inventory high back in July 2021, when interest rates were, down in the twos and the threes, meaning rates have not had the effect on inventory that would have had to have happened in order for Freddie Chief Economist Lynn Kiefer's statement to be accurate.
On the other hand, Chief Economist Lynn goes on to say a couple of things. One, the average conforming loan size is actually down from its peak by a full 8%, suggesting a softening in the market.
True that, but the average conforming loan balance is still a whopping 25% higher than it was just back in 2020. Do the math on this one here, guys. And if you take the new monthly payment with a higher interest rate that we now have, even though loan amounts are down by 8% off of the peak, the payment on that 8% lower house is a striking 35% more than it was a year ago. Over the past year, on average, we've added $670 to the average principal and interest.
Now, this might be confusing, but check out the mortgage payments, interest rates, and loan size graph. You'll notice a clustering effect, don't you? From the year 2000 on the far right to the year 2021 on the far left, all the numbers for all the years dating back over 20 years follow a pattern down there. That is all but one year, that being 2022 right now.
Check it out, 2022. It's north on the graph and outside of anything that we've seen over the past 20 years when we factor in payment rates and loan amounts. It's nearly, literally, off the charts here, guys. So what does that mean? Well, this is how what I said just a couple of moments ago with loan balances going down, yet the payment is going through the roof. Why? Well, mainly because of the Fed's desire to try to rein in inflation and lower their balance sheet, forcing interest rates to double over the past couple of months.
Maybe that's the problem. Even if home prices slip, payments still go up. Because we have so little inventory that even what should be something of a reprieve just isn't working out.
And guys, we talked about this before with Stephanie and her. It's your home for life, it's not your loan for life. When we had Barry on the show a couple of weeks ago, we talked about this absolute very scenario playing out, and it is. Just remember the second chapter though of that conversation, that being rates dropping back down once we come to terms with the fact that we're going into our inevitable recession. And my friends, that's just food for thought for you. Keep your nose down, keep grinding. Doesn't matter what's gonna happen with rates or with inventory for those who work hard.